Hi. Hi, Susan. And hi, Kenny. Oh, you're so fast. I love you. oh my God. I have to mute myself. Oh, thank you. Lord. Hey, Kenny. Hi. Good to see you. Hi, Mia Bear. Hey, Joey. Christina, hi. Hi, Faye. And I said hi to Mia and Kenny. Elizabeth, hi. Hi, Lindsay. Welcome, welcome. Good to see you. And Beth, hi. Susie, hi, Wendy. Essie, hi. Welcome to you all. Hi, Heather. Oh, by the way, Heather, I have two of you. Maria. She is all done now. She had eyelashes and all. She's awesome. Veronica, hi. Becky, Pamela, hi, Faye. Michelle, hi. Louise, hi. Oh, Melody. Oh, my share. You're not sleeping yet. Hi, Lisette. Kijun, that's Pat. Hi, Pat. Hi, Donna. Hi, Nanamo. Melinda, hi. Fliss, hi. My God, so many is coming in. Hi, Michelle. Carola, hi. So hopefully I can grab Maria just fast and show her. So this is Maria, Orphan's lady, and she is all done now because she has gotten her pearl necklace that I made out of some Fimo clay, and she even got eyelashes. I don't know if you can, if it actually shows, but she has eyelashes. I was on this garage sale stuff yesterday, and there was this this one lady that actually sold fake lashes, so I got them. Thank you, Heather. She is sassy. Has some teeth in her mouth and all, and curls, and she looks just like my grandmother. So here she is. So I just had to show her. Thank you, everybody, and thank you, Louise. Mostly that she is. Thank you, Melinda and everybody. Hiya, Kate. Hi, Pickle. Hope I have said hi to everybody and not missed anyone. But if I have, I'm so sorry. You are welcome here as well. But the chat is going quite fast, and English is not my first language, so. I miss a lot of chat because I kind of have to translate everything, and I read quite shallow on English as well. Hi, Selina. Hi, Darlene. Katrina, hi. You get a heart as well. So, if I'm missing anybody, I'm so sorry. Chat rules, if you are talking to me, please put it in all caps, then I have a higher chance to actually see it. If I miss it, just try once more. If not, my mods and other people in chat are always so helpful. So hopefully they will help you out as well. Hi, Karen, welcome. Another thing you can chat about more or less every thing, just not negative stuff. I don't like anyone being a Debbie Downer. I don't want any drama or sad news. So, besides that, we can all chat and have some fun. Thank you, Beth. So, I don't know if you guys know this book, but this is Nordiska Vesen, made by a Swedish guy called Johan Egerkrans. So, he actually makes, or he illustrates Scandinavian fairy tale books. But he has also put out made a coloring book out of his sketches. So, and these are all sketches from Scandinavian or the Nordic fairy tales, like our mermaids are not of the beautiful, shiny, nice type. Our mermaids are the deceiving one that fools shipsmen and sailors. And yeah. So this is a fairy, like a typical Nordic fairy. Oh, Heather, I'm so sorry. I'm happy that you are back. Yeah, Beth, I like this book as well. I have a clip of it on my channel that I did a long time ago, but I want to show it again because I think that this is a book that is collected, and it's and it has a variety of small images and full pages. So we also have fairies that are this small, or our fairies are like a small child or even down to the size of a mosquito. So this is one of them. This one has this typical Swedish folk hat. So this is a fairy man riding some if it's a parrot or something. Thank you all. You can get it, or at least you could get it from Etsy out of 70s books. I will find it and post the links. Actually, I do think that I saw one on Amazon as well. So this is our mermaids. And this is our what is called Askefroa. It is kind of a fairy living in the forest. So this is the different sides of Nisse or a Tomte, which is kind of like a gnome. And this is a mermaid. So that's kind of similar to what you are used to. And this is a merman actually as well. Sometimes fishermen caught these mer babies in their net and pulled them up and actually raised them as their own children. But sometimes all of these mer people jumps back into the sea. Because the sea is calling them. And of course we have troll, like an ogre. So this is one of them. This is a typical Norwegian turtle. Quite big and stupid and slow. Hi, Gary. And everybody. Hi, Charlotte. Yeah. So, again, another gnome thing. Kvarngubbe. Another forest Knipperi Knitia. So this is like the queen of the forest, riding her reindeer or a big moose. Another little gnome thing. And of course we have these mermaids living down in the sea. We have something that is called a nøkken, which is a kind of like a merman, but he is playing music and are luring people into the water. He is often found in a waterfall or a river. This is another one. This is a bigger one that lives under the sea. Nøkken finns also in lakes and even in oceans. This is a porous troll, and here you can also see how small some of our fairies are. They are butterfly size. Thank you, Mia Bear. Thank you, Michelle and everybody. So this is a troll woman of the old kind. Oh, and I made a bit like this. Yeah, I like that. That's probably better that I have done. Different kinds here. Some are riding this. There is a small one looking at her. Shouldn't look at me. There's one. The Swedish has something they call a vitror. It is forest gnomes of different kinds. So this is a female one, another one who has a toad in his backpack, and this is the one that I thought that we were going to do today, so I just put a paper behind. Here is a little sample of different types of fairies, not the cute kind. These are more like mosquitoes. This is something that the Swedes call an mjölkare. It's a milk hare. Stealing milk out of cows on farms. And this is when I translate it, it's actually nightmare. Hi, Faith. Oh, thank you so much, Faith. Have a nice day or a rest of your day. You're on the BB game. Well, thank you for popping by. And of course we have variables, and we have different types of. This is another, or this is a ghost grown up, and we have a child one. We are coming now to a one I have colored as well. This is called a myrling or a myrtling. This is a child that a mother has killed but never and buried, and she will come back until somebody gets what's happened and something like that. Nattram, this is just some ravens. This is kraken, we have that as well. Often you only see like the smaller island in the ocean, and you have the full animal underneath. So, and of course we have dragons, tons of them, different sizes and colors and shapes. And we have kyrkogrimen, or the Swedish ones have that. It's a animal who are kind of guarding the churches. So this is another dragon type, but this is what we call a linnorm, or a worm. It's and a little fairy form of was a sweet one, and of course this little baby fairy. So that was flip to do of this book. So I just wanted to show you all, so you can I will find link and post it in when we are done, and I have uploaded all of this. I also want to share, if I can find my mouse, that is, I want to share right now a link to, if I can find Celine, I will post that as well. Or maybe one of my mods actually can find a link to Celine that is on after me, but I will also post a link to Color with Faithful Girl 1978, that is Belinda. She has a kind of a special event today, and she, I believe that is actually her birthday as well. So I will post a link to her there. There you are. So that is that. So she has something very special coming up. And thank you so much, Mads. You are awesome. I want to color this guy. I think. Or maybe actually. Or the ogre. I don't know. The troll. But I. Oh. Let's stick to this one. But I kind of need my easel. So I get lifted up a little bit. Hopefully we won't be too high up. Oh, I will. Oops. I'm sorry. See, like that. Hopefully we can get it to fit. Come on. Page point. There. I need more clamps, I think. God, this wasn't that easy. I won't close it totally because I might want to lift it up and stuff. that's all okay, Connie. That's fine because we have somebody else here as well. So no worries at all. And it's no point that everybody jumps on that one. Idiot. So, I want to use today my Graphitint together with my Inktense because I haven't done that in ages. And just because I feel like it. And I have to turn my oven off because I'm getting fried here. Just hang on. So now you can chat amongst yourself. So I will just take off this metal from the Derwent Graphitint. But I need something darker as well. My set of Graphitint doesn't have like really dark gradients. So I would like to use something from the Inktense for getting that. Thank you, Connie. Yeah, I think so too. Because in this book, for some kind, or yeah, some reason, I actually like the earthy tones. Just because it kind of speaks to me. This Ionian green, I think, might be good for the darkest area. So I will just put that in around this. Now, this is a toad, not a frog. And I know that toads should be brown and ogre colored. Ochre. Let me see. I think it looks kind of washed out. If I taking that out, does that help? Now I have dimmed my light down. Hopefully, that is a little bit better on camera. Yeah. So okay, like that maybe. Yeah, so I know that it should be ochre or brown, but I like him to be green. And after all, it is my book. So I do this I want to. So I'm putting this Ionian green from the Inktense set on the outer edges, where I want the darker parts to be. And, hi Sargat! Welcome! Welcome, welcome! And the Graphitint pencils, for those of you who doesn't know them, they are water soluble graphite pencil with colors, or with a hint of color. You will see, I will show you. Maybe that is a part of, or I can make that into a cushion that he's sitting on. Thank you, Michelle. I do too. Because that is the sound of a happy dog. That has every thing it needs. And of course, the one who walked Over now. Something like that. That is his harness. Just put it some darker. In here and there. I will go back later and put in more shadings and stuff. So yeah, I will use my Graphitint. Oh, so sorry, I forgot. But the good news is that then you can stay up and watch them. Linda later to a day or to a night, I mean, because she is doing something so super fun on her channel. Yeah, Karen, me too. I didn't used to like the earthy toned down colors, but I do now. I don't know if it's age or what it is, but it seems like the older I get, the more I like the earthy colors. And I have ordered the last 5 pencils in this set, so I soon, when my Texas Art package comes, we'll finally have them all. Oh, and I am just on top chat. I must have probably lost some of it. Yeah, chat is moving fast. And hi, Robin. Welcome, welcome. You talk to the super user people last night. Oh, Lisette, I'm using both my Inktense and the Derwent Graphitint. Graphitint, yeah. Which are water soluble graphite pencils with some colors. So the colors that are in the set now, I still need 5. They are on their way. 6, no, 5, because I got the white one as well. But the colors are very toned down, very earthy. So I like this set. But as it only has, it's just 36 colors, I have to use something else that did it. And then I'm using my Inktense. Of course I could use watercolor or all of Direct Durer. Andrea, hi! Welcome! It's just too bad that I have so few colors yet. I'm hoping that I will get more. And this is not a regular butter. This is actually an old Winkle Stella, which I have opened up and cleaned all the parts, so when it was empty. And then I filled it up with water, and I are using that because I found that that actually works often much better than many of these water Ja, det känns det ljuget. Somehow, I find that this have more or less a perfect water low, because other has to or give out way too much water or too little water. But this one, I actually find that gives just perfect amount. So I'm just wetting all of this and pulling the pigment up into the lighter areas. And mixing those two colors. I'm not using any water out because it flows by itself. Yeah, carisatin. It is. And it's one that actually works so super. I actually like this much better than many of my other water brushes. And I actually have a lot of them. Both expensive ones like the current brush. And I have super cheap ones that I have gotten with sets or from like Ali or Wish for nothing. But the Bingo of Stella works amazingly. Spreading it down, wiping some off. Oh, how I feel it, Pickle. You just screw it open. And then it has inside, it has this thick inside. I don't know if it, yeah. It has this one, and you just take it up and lift it out. You can put it in when you're done, but I just didn't. And it has this small silver bullet. I just keep that in it and screw it on. And of course you can take the tip out as well. Clean the bunch inside. You can even take that off because it's loose. Clean all parts. But of course, it is hard to get every thing off. So the first few pictures usually have some dark color in it. But that's okay. So. I have a bit about that as well, where I show how to do it. How you open it, pulling it out. Whatever you need to know is on that video. I have a list which I have called how to I don't know if it's called how to how color or only how to, because I show different things there. It's not that many videos on it, it's like 10 videos, but those can be quite handy, and they show things like this. They are a year old now or something, most of them. So they, yeah. And since I usually don't mention my channel or my videos to anyone, they're not really that known either, so. I also show how I set pastels with water. Both show the kind of the easy way or that it can be done, and I show how I work with that when I do that in a coloring book with light layers of pastels and not that much water, and building layers rather than putting one down thick or putting down one thick layer. Thank you all. Oh, thank you. This Dean, you are so nice. Because I don't mention my own videos or channel like to anybody. I mention yours, and I mention other ones as well. Sargot and Connie. Caroline and now Becky. Becky has gotten an awesome channel as well. It's just that I hardly catch her live, but I watch them back. Well, not all, but some. And they are awesome. Becky is a natural. And for coloring hair and skin and stuff, then Sammy is just amazing. I have to mention Sammy as well to everybody. I'm kind of sending out links for it all. And Linda and her marker work, she is just amazing. Color with Paypal Girl 1978. The girl that I posted a link at, she is, it's called Copic Certificated or something, Certificate or something, but she does amazing marker work, so. And for watercolors, I follow a whole bunch of artists, and there's so many out there. Mickey said that he finished his think. Think about awesome, awesome. Oh, well, that's all. Okay, Becky, and hi, Becky. Thank you, Laura. I'm so happy that you like it. But my colors still looks a little bit washed out on my laptop. They look awesome on my phone, so hopefully it is looking good. Yeah, Mia. Linda is magical. She is just amazing. So we have to let him die up a bit, so we have to we can color some mushrooms with this. Let's see, what colors do we have here? That russet maybe would be a nice mushroom. The chestnut is a little bit too pinkish actually. Let me see, where is that russet? There it is. And Pickle, she has an awesome channel as well. Thank you, Pickle. Thank you, Karen. Pickle has a channel. It's called Coloring by Little Pickle. she has this video of where she and her niece and nephew is coloring or doing the pick 10 challenge, and it's so super cute. So you should really jump over to see her. And of course, carry on Suki and the kitty. Has also an awesome channel, and both Karen and Connie's energy is just so relaxing and so soothing. I love them both, and both color amazingly. Karen also use inks a lot. She does magic with that. Yeah, so good. She is a well of knowledge when it comes to watercolors and pigments and stuff. Yeah, she knows everything. So if you have any questions about watercolors and pigments or watercolor paper or whatever, if she doesn't know it, she will find out. Several times we have had a chat, and she has gotten an idea, and she arouse herself over that and do some research, and then she comes up with a video. So she is amazing. She's just so awesome. And like I said, she is a well of knowledge. Beth, these are the Derwent Graphitint. Hopefully you can see it without the glaring. If I lift it up, maybe it will be better. A little bit like that. Graphitint. Graphitint. And they have these really earthy tones. They are awesome. Why would I want to color in the purple toads? Oh yeah, my mods were faster than me. Thank you, mods. You are awesome. So, let's see what we will do with this guy. Maybe I actually want him to be like a like this cocoa bottom. I do think so. Oops. Oh, was that what? No, that was a cool bottom. Oh, Beth, I was a Derwent fan for years. I just love that company, and tested out more or less every thing they had out by then. But of course I didn't like it also, but they do make a lot of awesome stuff. Maybe I want something lighter as well. I don't know, I have to check my Inktense to see if I... And I do think that this one goes very well together with the Inktense, because the Inktense are very vibrant colors. Okay, Karen. I'm sure that you will like them, because they are very earthy. And I do think that they will fit your colored things style. I don't know if I want the amber or maybe actually the tan. Oh, I think I want the amber. Yeah. Blindfold engaged. I'm sorry, what did I miss? You cannot look back in. No, okay. That's... because several of my first videos was on Inktense for beginners. But of course we can do that again, I don't mind. These are Inktense as well. Now I'm just putting and these photos are this is the amber. And now as I have the locks, I can actually show them as well. So I guess that I should make a Inktense video now to actually show all what they have, because now I have everything. I'm so lucky. Oh, me too. Karen, I love my Inktense. Awesome pickle. Awesome. Oh, so I got only one. Oh my god. I have worn out so many things. Both pencil and a whole lot of other stuff. What I have used out most, I guess, is the Sakura jelly rolls. How many I've used of them, I don't know now. I have not any chance to count them. But I did get like 12 new ones now from Cult Pens of the 05. And I bought, I don't know, was it 5 of the 10, because I had 2-3 extra of those. And of course my skin color pencils. Used up skin colored pencils both in Prisma colors, and there I've used several Polychromos, and I think even one Luminance. Yeah, well, the color stuffs are actually my one, or the shortest one there is actually the orange one. I know. But I did this big tiger in an Orphea, and there I did, or that actually took more or less half my pencils. Yeah, Melinda, they are only 24. Yeah, can I guess so. Oh, Pickle got the 36 set of Inktense. Awesome! Then you are set to go, girl. His hat, I wanted to be kind of a dark blue. Actually, maybe that navy blue from the Inktense would be a nice color for him. Navy blue, let me see, where in the world do I have it? There it is, navy blue. This is the navy blue from the Inktense. I could show you Pickle really that's not how I usually work with my Inktense to keep a highlighted area and get a gradient color. I'm just putting some down, mostly on the outer edges. This one I'm putting it also in the darkest areas. I'm putting the Inktense in. I don't color all of it, just the outer edges and a little bit further in if it is a big area. But I don't color it all, because Inktense goes a long way and it's so easy. What? There is a 72 set of Graphitint. Really? I've never seen them because Jackson Art sell them open stock. That's where I get mine, and they have 24 colors, I think, or max. Or are you sure? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 24. No, it is actually a little bit poor. Anyway, so I go in from the lightest areas with my water brush, wetting that first, working my way slowly into the colored area while I'm pulling the pigments out into the middle of this part here, and then working my way in. And as it gets more pigment, or more pigment is getting wetted, the darker it actually gets. So, like that. If I want more pigment further out, I'm just pulling some of it out. But I'm keeping my highlighted area still very light. The 72 is on the Derwent website. Oh, since the phone ship to the US, well, I'm not in the US, so if they are on the Derwent page, then I should be able to get it. But, or then again, I did order my Devil Pen and Derwent kind of messed that up, so I had a lot of issues later on with the custom and all. But it, we sorted it out, so I just don't want to have to go do all of that again. And a 72 set would cost so much that it would get or come tax and stuff on it. Oh my god, it's only 24 colors. So it is 72 pencils, but only 24 colors. Hi, Simi.
Hi.
Sensitivity regulation. Yeah, of course, Robin. America has very hard safety rules. I know some pigments are not legal there. While in Europe we only like label them do not eat and it's okay, but I forgot to call the under. It says only 24 colors. Yeah, okay. Well then it's okay because I can get them open stock at Jackson Art. Hi, Josie! Little Noodle! Hi! Okay, well then we sorted that out. His shoes, maybe have them dark blue as well, just like his hat. Watching the time, I have 1 hour left. Oh, Rochelle, this value is the Derwent Inktense, but I also use the Derwent Graphitint, which are also both soluble. You can see it has this brush symbol on it. It's the Derwent. Hi, Belinda. Good morning. You have birthday today. Well, if you do, then happy birthday. I won't sing for you right now on my channel. Don't want my subs to be in pain, so happy birthday, Belinda! Awesome, awesome. So that was one shoe. What kind of color do we want the rest of his outfit? Maybe something red on that part on there. And that cushion that I put that he's sitting on, we need a color for that as well. But maybe we will keep the jacket kind of blue and his vest red and golden buttons. I think that would be nice. I need to find someone in the UK that can... Well, you can get all of them open stock and the inset, I guess, from jacksonart.uk. I think it's uk or .com, I'm not sure. But Jackson Art sells them open stock. So this autumn brown is a reddish color from the Graphitint. I can actually make those lines up there golden as well, same as the buttons. I'll put this so like that and down here. And with a water soluble pencil, you don't need to be so neat and don't be scared of. Thank you, Belinda. Thank you, thank you. You can mix them, but they rivet really easily, so layering them can be challenging. You can do it if you have like light layers, then it's easy, it's here. So yes, you can layer them, but it's not that easy. Inktense is much easier to layer because when they dry up, they are permanent, so they don't move. But the graphitint can move. I don't quite know what's coming down there. Okay, I just put that to be his shirt. And we'll go lines up there. And a yellow scarf. Thank you, Mia Bear. Thank you, thank you. Yeah, maybe that's Hargot, that is a paper. Probably, because I only use them on watercolor paper like one time. So I will take another blue out. Maybe we'll just keep on with this navy blue actually on his jacket. And on the watercolor paper, they was awesome. I did this lighthouse in a small, or in my sketchbook actually, with them. And that was awesome. Am I getting? Oh, April Sarah is live now. She's usually not on at this time. Well. Guess she has some books to show. So that is perfectly fine. Like that. Yeah, Inktense you can actually use on anything, really. And that goes with all of them, both the pens and pencils and Bardox. So, I have seen this awesome videos of girls coloring their, what to call them, tote bags, or those handbags that you use when you go out shopping, and they use the Inktense both box and pencils, and it looks awesome. There was a small button. I will have to keep that uncolored, so I have a chance to make it golden. Like this. So, that. Here. And yes, I get why she is live now and not when she used to be live, so that's perfectly fine. I don't mind that at all. But I need to close something down here. What I'm using? Belinda, I am using both the Inktense and the Graphitint, both from Derwent. Because I really love the Graphitints, but they are very muted. They are very earthy colors or has that. And I do love that, but it's only 24 colors, and like it doesn't really have any real yellow or like a real red or yeah, it's lacking many colors. So I'm also using some of my Inktense. This is the golden yellow, so I'm pulling that out for his scarf up here. Maybe that was silly on me because I want this to be. Yeah, I guess so. Okay. Eraser to the rescue, or if somebody wants to push the panic button, they can. But I can erase this because, after all, Inktense is a pencil and it can be erased. Probably not as easy as other, but it can be. Hey, Helle! Welcome! No, that is... no, it's not a color tint. It's a Graphitint, and it is the actual name of these pencils. Made by Derwent. Like you see, the Inktense are actually called Derwent Inktense. These are Graphitint. Yes, Joyce, I think I have a panic button, don't I? I need one. If I don't know, I guess that maybe one of these one might work. So, I don't know, the full on ripper, hot, wet, cheeky, shallider, and no idea, but I guess that this is the panic button! Let's hear. Well, that was kind of a panic, that was a very slow panic. I don't know, maybe this one. Yeah, okay, that's better. But I actually do need a panic button. I should download something that sounds like a car alarm or something. Going woo 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 woo. Or something like that. I don't even know how a panic button works. Or how it sounds, I mean. But so where did I go with my blue? Oh, I'm sorry, Melinda. I'm so sorry. Yeah, Donna. That was a panic button with some gas. So, I'm just coloring some. And you see, people, I don't color the whole image. I'm just coloring the inner edges. Because when I wet this ink, sometimes I can pull the colors out to where I want them, like here. I'll also start in the uncolored section, wetting that, and then I can pull the pigment up to where I want it as I go, making it much easier to avoid making a whole lot of mud. Thank you, Mia. Thank you. I'm happy that you like it. So let's wet this golden yellow color. Maybe we should can actually put some of that on the buttons as well, because it was a nice golden color. Like that. But we need another color on his scarf up there and his pants. Maybe we'll actually give him red pants as well. Can look like a little soldier. Oh, Michelle, you are so right. But I need a panic button that actually goes off. Okay, Kate. Take care and have fun. Yeah, you are right. Panic buttons usually don't make any sounds. Ooh, a little bit of his leg actually showed down here, so I have to pull out that russet color. I think it was that we used for his skin. That is his cushion that he's sitting on.
Yeah.
That. We can pick some of this yellow up as well from the tip. And we just put it down because we had such a small area there. Like that.
Now I'm kind of mixing everything here.
For the lightest part of his skin, we used this one. This was the russet. That, and we use the cocoa. I guess so. If not, it doesn't matter. It's not that important. I think the lightest areas first, and then the darkest one, or else the darkest color will eat up all of the light color. He needs a color on his. Is it called a pipe in English too? I think I need that chestnut color. That is actually kind of. There it is. Brown with a lot of red. Like that. I can try to zoom in a little bit because I know when I start with those small parts, some want me to zoom in. I can try to zoom in just some, like that maybe. Oops, don't wiggle. Come on, stop it. Thank you, Mia. And we pull him a little bit further down, just like that maybe. Still in fair aim, hopefully. Thank you, Charlotte. Thank you. Or Charlotte. I mean, but this pencil actually makes it quite easy to do it. We need some darker brown reddish thing down here, between his shirt and his pants, because it's a very shaded area down there. So I used a color that is called Cool Brown. Yes. That. To pick up my yellow again because I need some down there. That little button there did not get enough color, so we just try to dab in a little bit more, like that. That. To check my battery just to see we are good, and of course I can't see it. Why can't I see my battery? Okay, anyways, I do think that I have to plug it in just in case, so we don't. Oh, look at that. What says turn the unit? Why? Come on, like that, and then like that again. Okay, good. We are back on track. When it just stops wiggling, and I'm so sorry for those of you who are easily motion sick. So, like that. Then I actually can push him a little bit further up. Just some, I guess. So, his cushion that he's sitting on, and his, of course, his scarf and his nose. We have to be bedding back some teeth and some fur lines up there. Nose had to be
and quite dark. Maybe actually a black one, but this Graphitint black is like more like a really dark gray. And that was dark indigo. That was not the black one. Midnight black, there it is. Or maybe I can actually lift it off the tip. Just like this. Like that. That's good. That's good enough. What kind of eyes do we want them to have? I don't think that it matters that much because I will anyways. Let me just find a black pen. Thank you, Melinda. Thank you, Gary. Okay, night night. I was hoping that maybe you could join us over at Linda's later on, but you can watch it. Recap, I guess. Like that. And we need to... Oh, come on. Get out some more highlights. Where is my... There is my jelly roll of 5. Let's put some white in it. It already has some, but... Mm-hmm. I do think I need some eyelashes. I don't know, it's something about me and putting eyelashes on everything I have. See, this is on 030. It's like a really tiny one. Let's see. I can give him some eyelashes. Yeah. You might not see it, but I do. We have to bring back a little bit of his teeth because I kind of color over it like that and that. We need to grab a pencil and just okay, I will leave it out to clean later on. Something, yeah, like this one. This is the chestnut. Something underneath the teeth because I'm sure that he doesn't have pearly white teeth. Something like that. Oh, I forgot to wet the pipe. And if some of you shouted at me, I'm sorry that I didn't see it. Thank you. I'm happy that you think he's cute. So, his harness, I believe, should be this, that chestnut color as well, actually. Because that kind of stood out a little bit from that, this one down here. And his backpack. And this is the darkest color down here. It up there. We need something lighter. How does this backpack go? I think okay, let's do it all the way down here. And something a little bit more yellowish from the Inktense. Oh, and my laptop is buffering. My phone is not, so I guess that we are good. I hope that we are. So this is the amber again. So I'm putting that on together with that Graphitint. Because that has a little bit of yellow in it. So it will be kind of a brownish with yellow in the highlighted areas, and then it turns more reddish in the darker areas. Like that.
this cushion.
That was that again.
I just need a sip of my coffee. Should the scarf be like greenish, green, or something? Because I don't know. Forgot what book it was. Okay. What will I do? Wonders with. Well, anyway. Thank you, Charlotte. Thank you. Or do we want that scarf to be like really red, like a royal red? Decisions. They are hard to make. Okay, B. Take care. Bye. And thank you for coming. Yeah, I will pop you later, B. Because I know that you have something up your sleeve that I really, really, really want to see. And I have told everybody here that they should jump on over and watch you to a night as well, since you have a special birthday show with a lot of fun in it. So I'm looking forward to it. Yeah, yes, Mia, she has a secret guest too. It's going to be so much fun. I'm sure that it will. You always do amazing stuff. So I'm coming over. I might not be there the whole time, but I will pop by, as I usually do. Yeah, so the colors on this poor guy's scarf and that cushion again. I really can't decide what I want it to be, actually. Let's see, that green... maybe I want that... Oh my god. The thing is that if I take the red Inktense and put it on there, we can't take it off if we don't like it. Anyway, I do think that I would like that vivid green on this cushion, maybe. Purple. Yeah, maybe we actually should do purple. Will that match? Well, we do have something red and something blue there. If there is this kind of purple or aubergine, or it's called juniper, which is kind of a purpley or maybe more violet, and we have the aubergine. So we actually, the aubergine or any of them actually could match. Let's do them. Let's take them out. Let's see. What is this? That's the juniper. And the aubergine. Okay, Heather. Have a good night. And I'll see you around. Take care. Yeah, egg plant. Aubergine and eggplant, that is kind of the same thing, isn't it? Because in Norway we kind of call it squash. No, we don't. We call it. We call it. I don't know anymore. Anyways, I'm putting the lightest color, this juniper, on the top here. Also in the middle of this scarf, because that is where the lightest area will be. Actually, his harness can be. Oh, I want that to be gold, actually. Forget it. And then the aubergine, which was the darkest color, I'm putting down in the darkest areas. So it will look more shaded all by itself. And put like really dark up there and underneath down there. Then I will take my wrinkles. If you want blue, but aubergine is far enough away to run blue. Yeah. I don't really want blue scarf. I was thinking red or green actually. But this will do. And of course we that yellow down first with the mistake, so I'll just push that a little bit down. Again, when I'm going in and wetting it, I'm wetting the lightest areas first and pulling that light color into the dark instead of the other way. Because if you do it the other way, very easy that the dark color eats up the light color and it all turns into one color, and that you don't want. This is the darkest one, something like that maybe. And then we didn't wet his harness coming up there, which was going over his back or to his backpack there. That nose harness right here. This is the golden yellow again from the Inktense set. That down. And his eyes are, and the small things here I will color with pencils. Way. Yeah, it's nice. It's working. Yeah, night night, Heather. I will see you around. So maybe I was just clean up some of my mess just a little bit at least. We can color some of these leaves, but that I believe I want to do with the Inktense, because I used the I haven't used the ivy from the Graphitint, and it's actually a very nice green, so I can find that. You can, there it is. Put up in those leaves. Oh, the artisas. I hope that some are using them. I don't, but I'm sure that some can help you out. Let's see what kind of the iron green, maybe. Will that be? Actually, that beach green is actually a nice green from the Inktense set as well, to be a little bit darker than the I think this is it. Hopefully it is. So we have this ivy. I actually can just put all over the leaf that, because it's such a light color anyways.
I'm just putting down a light layer. Oh, they are really good. Awesome. So good. Thank you, Charlotte. Yeah, I like the purples. And the Graphitint colors, they all work so good together. And that's why I hope that they will make more colors in these sets. Because there are all some colors that they lack. But all of them actually goes to together. I need something of the yellow, like brown. I think maybe something yellow, like this, not sun, or maybe tan actually. I use that. No, I use amber. Right down. So this is the tan from the ink tense set. So I'm just putting that on the edges. Down there. Looking them, or making them look a little bit old. Maybe it's a start of the fall, or something like that. Thank you, Pickle. Thank you. I'm happy that you like it. So I go in again, wetting from the lightest areas, and just working my way up to the medium areas, and then the darkest one. Blending it all together. Like that. And that is what is so awesome with any water soluble pencils, is that you don't have to blend them, because the water makes it so easy for you to blend colors, because it kind of flows together by themselves. That. Then we have a leaf. So we have to what is his name? Oh yeah. If I did give him a name. No, not yet. I haven't named any of these ones. So I'm sure that any name would be good. I think that we should use this golden or gold uniball. I have this signal uniball. People usually have this one in white. I have that too, but also I have in silver and gold. Pigment ink gold. Mine is actually quite old. I guess I should. Oh, Pickle, you will master them, I'm sure. Because they are so fun, so you will use them a lot. And when you use something a lot, then you actually will master it eventually. Whether you kind of think it or not. Just because things are fun. We use a lot, and then we get better with it. It has this whip thing up here. I don't really like that he has that, but he does. Or maybe we can call it a fishing rod. That that was a gold. I put that away. I need something brown for this. This is a Sakura. No, it's not. It's a Copic at you. Spike up. Okay, Celine. Thank you for popping by. I will send people over in half an hour. I might not join in because I have to clean up and walk my dogs and stuff, but if I can, I will pop by. And if I don't, then have a wonderful live show. I hope that you, or I know that you will have fun because you all the best do. Putting that in that shadow area there. That one, and then the poor dog's or toad's eyes. But for that, I actually need some pencils. Let's see what I got. I have some polychromos here. I do think that I will use something dark orangey thing and a orange and a yellow, just because I believe that Tools has this typical reptile eyes. Maybe they don't, but or maybe that is only the red-eyed tree frog. I don't know, but mine will have. So this is just polychromos. You don't have to have them. Any pencil will work as long as you have a orangey red and a orange or a dark yellow and a lighter yellow. This yellow I just go over everything with. The frog could be a rower. Yeah. Okay, so this frog is called rower. I need a pencil so I can write that down. Here's something. Rover. Oh, then he got to be a Roger. Roger and a Rover. Like that. So we have Roger riding on a Rover. You were thinking Yodel for the guy. is Yodel even a name, Joyce? It's not a name in my country. In my country, Yodel is an app. I think it's some kind of a dating app or something. So I think it's a dating app. I don't have it, but. Or it's called Yodel. Michelle wants him to be called Rick and Dick. Okay, so who's who? Well, after all, I know who's been whose legs, so. So I guess that this is Rick with his dick between his legs. Mm. Anvils are got the Mondelus are actually very good pencils for the cost. Or at least here they are quite cheap. For what you pay for them, they are awesome. I will get again something. Oh, come on. Black, this is just as a micron pen with a pin tip. Getting the black back in his eyes. Some of that there. Look at that. And we need again some white. But now I need more. Well, Pickle, everything in the world needs names. Imagine if things didn't have names. It would be impossible to know what everybody was talking about. Something like that, maybe another one, that bigger, higher up, maybe. I have no idea how to highlight Frog's eyes or Mr. Dick's eyes. You have to get on the road, okay, Kenny? Have a wonderful journey wherever you are going, and stay safe and good luck. Bye. So now we, what do we need? I want to shade a little bit more around the guy and stuff. So I will pull out my indigo from the Polychromos set. Hi, Caroline, and welcome. So I'm just shading with the dark indigo. First rule when I shade is to put shade where things is on top of something else. Like this cushion is on top of Rover's head. And we have some shades going down Roger's foot or his whole leg down here. And then of course we can, I will usually move my book, soften it out as well so it doesn't get to be like a hard line. We don't want that, because when we look at shadows, they do fade out. That, and then we want to shade under that arm. Hi, Vin! Well, that's okay. And I won't be on that much longer. A little bit on, or 15 minutes, maybe. Maybe not even that, because Shalene will be on exactly at midnight my time. So, and that is in 17 minutes. That. That harness, I want to shade a little bit more maybe. And then of course putting some shade down on the around under over. That will still show when I color the ground here. And Johan has actually put down a lot of shadows.
Novin, this is not pastel pencils. Actually, this is a Polychromos. But the rest of this is done with Inktense and the Graphitint. So actually, I haven't used regular pencils until just the eye of the rubber and the shadings now. But I do need, I need to get more of Roger's fur out actually. So I will just take this polychromos, this is the burnt umber, and just give him a little bit more fur coming out like that. Just like that, just so it looks a little bit more like fur. Oh, that got a little bit too long, but okay. So, and that rope there, I need to make that barrel. Going up there, like that. Okay, Veronica, hope that you have a good night, but it's over good. Thank you, Naika. Thank you, thank you. Oh, he had a little sweater, me as George. So, only thing that is actually left, I can zoom out now. Oops. Like that. That was a whoop, out. So what is left is actually the sky and some of the leaves back here, and of course the garden here. Garden we can actually do now with the rosette, like in the speed of the lightning. So today we did not sparkle anything up, but we worked with a or some pencils that not everybody know of. And because the polychromos are oil, or even if they were wax, when I put or wet this area with my water, it won't move, because wax and oil do not move with water. So we'll put in some grass at the back. And I finish this off on my own, I guess. That, then this is some of the cool the guy's name is Roger. Yeah. Okay, bye, and Karen. Have a wonderful night. For evening or whatever it is for you. At least I hope that you have a awesome rest of your Sunday. Of course I have to shade those leaves later on as well. So the toad's name is Rover, and the guy name, or that little vetta, that gnome, is called Roger. The froggy is called the rover. Maybe it was a little bit too light. Maybe I should. I can erase it and put and tap it in with the micron pen. Oops, something is falling down here. So this is rover. Rover. I hope that you can see it. And this guy is Roger. Like that. They will get a sky and stuff later on. Oh my god, I suck at this. So. Thank you, Mia. You are always so kind and so encouraging. You always are in my corner. Thank you so much. So I'm just wetting this. A little bit of water, so I can just pick it off with my finger. So. Maybe I should squeeze this and get out a little bit more of water actually. Because it would make it go faster. Give it a little push and it will come give me a little bit more water, or actually quite a lot more water, and it will give me some sparkle as well, because it's hard to get all of the glittery stuff out when you wash it. I don't mind a little sparkle. So, like that, and we can fill in some rocks and some stuff. And so, where did I put that? Cloth, I got it there. So, yeah, that, of course you can. Why shouldn't you? You can use anything over polychromos, more or less. You see that my shadings that I put down with my polychromos, that's this, because they are oil, and oil won't move. So, yeah, you can use watercolors, you can use anything, actually. No, not anything, because alcohol markers, they will dissolve it. They work just like solvent. So you can't use alcohol markers on top of polychromos. But watercolor and ink pens and stuff, that you can. No worries at all. So what I will do off camera is just to, I have to lift that up, it's just to give it a sky and put in some garden leaves. Yeah, Connie, that works just as well, because the supercolor colors, they are water soluble, aren't they? And Pablo's are, I guess that they are oil, or yeah. So they won't move. Oil and wax pencils don't move, but water soluble pencils do. So tonight we have been coloring this little, or these two guys, Rover and, oh my god, what did I do now? Hope I didn't shut everything. No, it works okay. So we did these two guys, working with the Derwent Inktense and the Derwent Graphitint pencils, and they look like this. And the Inktense, everybody have seen those. Those are the blue barons, and the Graphitint are the gray pencils from Derwent. Thank you, Pat. I'm happy that you like it. And we worked in, this is still a little bit wet. And you see the paper will buckle here where I put a lot of water, like really fast. But when you work with, just a damp brush, the paper stays flat and nice. So it doesn't buckle nor peel. We have been working from Schisse from Nordiska Vesen, a coloring book by Johan Egerkrans. I will lift that up so you can get to see his name as well. Like I said, I will try to link this when I'm done here. So that was it. Again, Belinda at Color with Faithful Girl 1978 is doing a special show tonight. She has a special guest, and they are going to do something something special. So her show today will be something extraordinary. Yeah, whatever. So I will put a link in for her. That is that. I hope to see everybody over at Belinda's. Shalene will be on next now in 4 minutes, so you can jump over to her. But and later on at Belinda. Belinda will be on in 1.5 hours. I don't know if Shalene maybe, she usually goes two hours, so, but yeah. Oh, Pat, but I don't mind if you go live when I am. I don't mind that at all, and that's probably big, or April knows that, that's why she went live, and Nick and Tina has been testing us as well, and I don't mind that at all, because I'm here just to have fun and to hang out around with all of you guys. So well, if you do a little test, then we will jump on if we can see it, and support you, say hi. So I hope to see everybody over at Belinda's in 1.5 hours. That's going to be super fun. And thank you everybody for coming. I am live on Wednesday and Sundays. Sundays it is 10 GMT plus 1. Us slow time for those of you who have to check the world catalog. And Wednesdays are 12 noon GMT plus 1 Oslo time. So that is like 5:06 Eastern Standard Time. I think it's 6 Eastern Standard Time. So that's quite early, so I get that not everybody can join in, but the Sundays should be good for a lot of people at least. Anyways, thank you everybody for coming. I have had some fun, and I hope that you have had that as well. So I'll see you all around, and bye.